power. Switchover taking place at this time, going on internal power. Countdown continuing to go well, T-minus 30.
We're still on a go, Delta 4.
T-minus 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18. Guidance released. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9. We have ignition sequence start. The engine's now building up to 7.7 million pounds of thrust. We have a launch commit and we have a liftoff. The swing arm moving back. The Saturn V lifting off the pad, building up thrust. We clear the tower.
You know, it's very fitting to have chosen a place that died to be the birthplace of the future.
It's perfect. A long abandoned missile site. It's absolutely perfect. Except for the one discrepancy.
The discrepancy can be rectified.
Are you here for the event?
I knew it. I knew you'd be back. They're gonna reopen the base, right? Oh, I've been guarding it, making sure nothing had happened to it. We couldn't do a space shot.
No, this man is not here for the event.
Are you one of those lady astronauts? I heard about that.
We are travelers, friend. And this is our point of embarkation.
I'll bet you're going to the moon. No. No, you've done that already. Hey, Mars, maybe.
How long have you lived here?
Since they built it. I'm the watchman.
Come into the shade and we'll talk. You look hot.
Hey, how do I know if you two are really astronauts? Maybe you don't belong here. Have you got papers?
We mean you no harm, friend. Come.
How did you two get here anyway? I didn't hear you coming.
Come inside. We'll talk.
is time.
You know what I like about Santa Fe Village? They can have a black tie concert in a gazebo for an audience of 12 people. There are more artists per square inch in this town than there are in Greenwich Village. Santa Fe gets its share of strange birds, too. I mean, they seem to flock here like it's some great nesting place. I came looking for my girl, Natalie. She's beautiful, independent, and I guess like all of us, a little crazy. Sometimes I tell myself, I'd have been better off staying away. And if I had, I wouldn't have gotten involved with the two of them.
It is time.
Weirdos. That's what Randall called them, weirdos. Now, Randall said he was the best reporter of oddball stories in all New York. He claimed he'd been tailing these two for 6 months. Said they called themselves evangelists at first, and that's when he got interested. Now he was wondering who was really crazy. Told me his editor had been leaving messages all over the Southwest, get home or get fired. He refused. He had this feeling, he said, that they were ready to make their big move, and he wanted to be there when they did. I checked every astronomer I could get to about the pentagonal shape in the sky. All they said was it was a freak cosmic occurrence. Yeah, sure it was.
It's time.
Y'all don't worry about the boy now. We'll take good care of him.
Mom, please don't go, please.
Come on, Martha. It's time.
Y'all take good care of the boy now.
You signed the papers, Sam? It's all legal?
It's yours for keeps, Jasper.
The boy, too?
May God go with him. town away. I mean, from Spencer and Lamb. Man, we give this up, we are going to be the biggest ad agency in the West Coast. We'll bill $18 million this year. $18 million.
It's time.
Yeah, I think it's about time we got ready to knock off Armbruster.
Lester? Go put on one of Arnold's bathing suits. We're going swimming. Where is Arnold?
I don't know.
Here you go. Smile. We're on our way to the promised land.
Promised land? You're sure putting a lot of faith in those two honkies, Dad.
They're not honkies, Amanda. They're special people.
Well, they're not black, are they?
They're not any color. And when you meet them, you'll see. They won't even notice that you're black.
Why? Are they blind, Daddy?
Just the opposite, honey. Just the opposite.
It's time.
No more papers to grade, and no more runny noses to wipe.
No more bills, no more mortgage payments, no more overtime to work. It's time. Come on, honey.
Bob, this key is stuck again.
So leave it. We're not coming back.
I'll be right back.
I'm coming with you.
Stay here. They're here.
Would you mind changing seats with me?
I'm sorry, I have to look for something.
Don't worry, she'll be here. This is where they told her to come.
Hey, what do you know about it?
I know you've come to the right place.
Well, wait a minute, sir. Sir.
It never occurred to me that Randall was just setting me up.
Beth.
Hurry it up, Martha.
Stop! Stop the bus!
All over the country, they've been holding these meetings. The two of them, calling themselves he and she. A lot of unhappy people out there, you know. Would just flock around anyone who calls themselves some kind of a messiah.
What's there, Dad?
Well, these two phonies hit on a real good gimmick.
It's the sign, child. It's the sign!
They claim to be from another galaxy. Fill their followers with talk about signs in the sky, glowing lights, all that kind of stuff. Well, I'm telling you, tonight, or maybe tomorrow, somewhere around here, they're going to be putting on their big show.
That's mighty interesting, Mr. Randall. Care for some chili?
No, thanks. Sheriff, I tell you why I'm here, and I tell you what's going to happen.
It's mighty tasty. You ought to try it. Besides, I get kind of lonesome eating here by myself. Go on, sit down. I'll fix your bowl.
No, thanks. I should be moving along.
You guys are all the same. You come to a town like this, and because it's small, you think we're simple. But what I want to know is, why is that great big news magazine of yours up there in New York is so concerned because a pair of Bible thumpers are having their revival meetings here?
And I'm telling you, it's a lot more than that.
Wives, husbands, even children. Abandoned because people are buying what these people are selling. I've seen it all over the place. What bothers me the most is that they don't just use words. They use tricks. Just give me some room, Sheriff. When I get my story, I will hand you over all the evidence you need to make the biggest bust of your career. Believe me.
Verge! Excuse me. Listen, we got a call about a crowd gathering out on 285. Something about a strange glow.
Bando, I'll see you out there.
Oh, Bob. Feel it?
I do, honey, I do.
What we're witnessing.
They've come. They're here.
The second sign, the landmark.
Here we will be joined by others who are traveling great distances.
It is time to shed all your remaining earthly possessions.
It is time to shed your earthly desires and fears.
Gather together only what you will need for sustenance.
When it is time, we will come for you.
People of tomorrow, it is the twilight of today.
Understand?
lights, sound effects, and at least one town, I was convinced they hypnotized the whole crowd. I'm telling you, they hypnotized them. Once they get their hands on people, they got them. Even your girl, kid. She heard about them. She listened to them. Now she's there.
This is Wild Oats. I'm going out to Ivo. What's happening out on 285?
You have any idea what you're up against, kid? A dream that's real hard to fight.
I get her back. We love each other.
Love won't do it, my friend. It's the reaching out for something she thought she could never be. And all of a sudden, it's right there within her grasp. It's like offering a starving, homeless man a seven-course meal in a room all to himself in a big, big palace forever. It's a dream that's hard to resist. That's what you're up against.
Breaker, breaker. 285 is crawling with smokies.
Get away from here. They came for us.
You want to move it back there, buddy? Come on now.
Everyone off his hands. Don't make trouble, just move it.
Don't push, man. Don't push, we're going.
Big Joe, this is Big Joe. I'm out at that rendezvous, and let me tell you, there's something going on out here.
These people out.
Let's go. Down you go.
You know any of them folks?
Damn. Feel the heat of that thing.
Yeah. All right. I want this whole area roped off. Then you call the Air Force. I want everyone kept away from here till we find out what that is.
In and out. No one's allowed up on the hill.
What's that there, huh? You seen it?
We have to find our people and stay together. And how will we know who they are?
Well, you'll know.
If you don't, you just ask. Are you people of tomorrow?
Yes.
We're trying to keep all our people together.
You ain't one of us, boy. You couldn't be.
Oh, come on, man. We're past all that. We left black and white behind us. Don't you understand that?
He's right, Sam. Where do we go?
This way.
Go on, move it. Oh, boom. Find that reporter.
Are you two here for...
Yes, but my wife's not feeling well. I don't think she's going to make it.
Look, don't worry. She'll be all right. We just have to get her out of this crowd.
Hey, come on now. Will you people please...
Tell us about it. We've seen you up there.
Can't you see that this woman's ill? You're just frightening her?
I'm asking you a question. Answer me. What's up there?
Just leave us alone.
You can't talk to us like that. What's out there, huh? You seen it? Are you aliens or something?
I'm gonna look for Natalie.
If you find her, bring her to meet me. I want to talk to her. I'll be at the top of the hill.
She's fine.
It's okay.
Nobody's allowed up there. Nobody's allowed up the hill.
Who is that guy? How come he got to go up?
There's nothing up there.
Just a light. Sheriff wants to see you.
There's nothing up there.
I have to rest you.
Come on. Just a light.
Whoa! I never expected anything this fancy.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Something like one of those Hollywood searchlight type things. But this is terrific.
Are you ready to tell me what's really going on around here?
Sheriff, I told you everything that I know.
But I'm telling you, if that's dangerous and somebody gets hurt, you're in one hell of a mess of trouble.
Dangerous? Sheriff, I'll bet you that if some of your men were down here amongst those rocks, you'd find nothing but a holographic or a laser projector. That's nothing more than an illusion.
Nah, we'll let the military decide that.
The military?
Yeah.
Sheriff, just do yourself a favor. And you call them back and just tell them that you made a big mistake.
Look, mister, if you had told me that that thing down there is a searchlight or something, I might have believed you. But you get on back over the rest of them civilians. Until you're ready to tell me what's really going on around here, don't ask me for none of them special favors or nothing.
All right, Sheriff. But you're letting yourself in for an awful lot of trouble.
It's not a child yet. It's unborn. Our baby's going to be the first one born in their world. Do you see?
Your baby will be very special.
How much did you get?
I didn't sell it.
Why?
$85. That's the most I got offered. It's worth 2-3 times that much.
$85 will buy a lot of food, honey.
Not here it won't.
Sell it, Bob.
Has either of you seen her?
She doesn't want to see you. She's afraid that you're going to try and make her leave, that you won't understand.
Look, I just want to find her and talk to her.
She knows you're here.
Let her find you when she's ready.
Please, just tell me where she is.
We can't.
Nothing to worry about, sir.
What'd you find?
Nothing.
Nothing? Last night down there, there was a light strong enough to light up 10 Astor domes.
And what happened to that light?
Well, by sunrise, it just faded like that.
Yeah, they always do, sir. We'll send you a copy of our report.
Now, what am I going to do with a report?
Same thing we do. File it away with all the others.
What others?
The other thousands of reports we've got just like it, filed away, taking up military space in government buildings. Look, you want to save yourself a lot of trouble? Call it a hoax and send those people home.
1950? $2,000.
You made a good bargain, mister. I'm a good mechanic, and I kept her up myself.
Hey, did you say that lots of folks out there in 285 be wanting to sell their cars?
I suppose so. We sure won't be needing them. Thank you, sir.
If we sell you our truck, can you carry me and my wife out to 285?
You bet I can. I hear they need old Smile Jack out there.
I don't know, maybe.
$950 is my top price. Take it or leave it.
But I paid $6,000 for it just 2 months ago.
He'll be here soon. He'll be going. Just get rid of the car, Tom. It doesn't make any difference.
Sarah, we're going to move, Mike. I can't take this.
It'll be all right. He'll be here soon.
Sarah, they're phonies. Just like this whole place. We came here expecting something new and wonderful. And what have we found? A carnival.
They're testing us.
No, we've been tricked. Sarah, we're not selling the car. We're going home.
There's nothing to go home to, Tom. Nothing.
Sarah, what are you saying?
I'm telling you that I'm staying.
Sarah, please. Sarah.
Stop! What do you want? What do you want? My ring? You got it. Where is it? Here, take it. Take it. You want my watch? You got it. Take it. My bracelet. Money?
You got it? Here. That's all. I don't need it anymore. Not where I'm going. That's all I got!
Oh.
Natalie! Don't run! Don't run! 2 years. 2 years together. And you split without leaving me a note?
I'm not part of your life anymore, Tim. I don't belong to you.
I have to understand what's happened. Look, let's get out of this chaos. Please, can we talk?
Okay.
Trouble
trouble starting, Burge.
Well, that figures. Anytime you get a bunch of people like this together waiting for something to happen that ain't gonna happen, then they start making it happen.
You just don't want to listen, do you?
I'll listen. As soon as I've lulled the sun to sleep. And for alone.
Sweet dreams, Mr. Sun.
Natalie had this screwy idea that she didn't want a single obligation in her life. She just didn't want anybody to expect something from her. You know, in a way, Randall was right about all the people who came here. They all felt the world had given them a bad break.
You folks have any kids?
We got...
None. Leastways, no more. We signed him away, legal.
That must have been tough to do that.
He and she don't take no kids.
Family don't matter no more. Because we finally are going to do something important.
Well, it must be important if you're willing to sign away your kid.
Well, don't make it sound bad, mister.
I'm a dirt farmer. You know what that means. Huh? Well, I'll tell you. If it don't rain too much, and if the sun shines just enough, and if the price of fertilizer don't go up too much, if I'm real lucky, I might just break even for a whole year's work.
Nobody considers folks like us important. I got so I hated my house, my kid, my husband. And then they started talking, and I looked at Sam, and we both knew.
They said they needed us, and they said we wouldn't have nothing to worry about.
Now, who did you give your kid and farm to?
That ain't none of your business. They've been took care of.
Sam, I'm feeling cold.
Real soon, Martha. Real soon. We're going where it is warm.
Your lip.
It's nothing.
Some of those people back there are really getting upset.
About what?
Well, they're starting to worry about whether they're really going to come get us.
Don't even be concerned.
It's different for guys like you and me. The two don't come to get us. You've got something to go back to.
How do you know what I have?
Gucci shoes, tailored clothes, Mercedes. What is it that they said to you that convinced you to come with them?
I don't even know if it was them. I've always had my African village syndrome. Drop everything and disappear into the jungle and live with a primitive tribe. Learn what makes them happy. Maybe teach them something useful.
Just like Albert Schweitzer.
No. No, not really. Too much responsibility.
I know what you mean.
but not anymore. Not when they come.
Hey, come on, Nellie. Look, we have to...
Have to? Order? What's the difference?
You're right. I'm sorry. No more orders. Look, how about I need to talk to you? How about I need you?
Sheriffs.
Sarah. You sold the car, Sarah. Please come home, Sarah. It's Tom. Sarah.
You'll come with me.
What?
We'll both go.
I thought...
Please, Tim, at least listen to what they have to say.
Okay, I'll listen. Then we'll make the decision together. We'll listen, and then we'll either both go home together, or we'll both go with him.
Great.
I understand I could find Sheriff Malloy around here.
Yeah, well, you found him.
It's all there, ain't it?
That's all here, but why?
I just deliver.
It is not yet time.
It will be. Soon. Is this the promised land they offered you?
No, Mandy. This is their way of showing us how ugly the world we're leaving really is.
Well, they're doing a good job of it.
Just be strong, Mandy. It may get a lot worse before it's over.
You know Reverend Joseph McLish. It's the name on this here permit.
I never heard of him. But you, nobody else has either. Look.
Look, that's my best price. Take it or leave it.
But you only paid $1,000 for it yesterday. Here's your money back.
No deal, no deal.
Please, I need my car to drive Sarah home.
Look, that's your problem, mister.
Please.
Look. If you ain't off my lot in 5 minutes, I'm gonna hose you off!
Head on home, Verge. Get yourself some sleep. I can handle it.
I think I'll stick around a while.
I don't think you ought to spend another night sleeping in the four-by.
Yeah, maybe you're right, Boone. I'll see you.
Find him.
Oh, why? Why, honey? Why did you come here? What happened to your face?
How did you find me?
Hey, you knocked inflation right off the front page, Arnold. Yeah, but what is going on out here? Is this a group therapy or something?
Shut up! Arnold, if it's a vacation you want, we can knock off a couple of days, honey. We can go to Vegas or Palm Springs, Acapulco.
A vacation is not what I mentioned.
This is for misfits and for losers who've got nothing else in their lives.
What about our work, Arnold?
Like punching up those ads so we can get a lock on the roller towel business in the 11 western states?
Are you leaving me, Arnold?
Well, let me tell you something, Mr. Big Shot.
I'll call it Joan.
No, now I want him to hear this. Now, you're not just abandoning your wife, but your partner.
Cat!
The people of tomorrow.
We welcome those who come only to witness the event.
We welcome and pity those who have come to scoff.
We welcome those who have come to...
Yeah, you better get your men ready.
And we welcome
the rest of them before this con of theirs gets way out of hand.
Not me, no, sir. Sheriff Malloy, you'd have to tend to something like that.
We come from another world. A place that resembles what your tomorrows may someday be.
That is what we offer. Our tomorrow. A tomorrow more wonderful than anything you have ever dreamed.
If you are troubled, if you are sick or disillusioned, come and talk to us. We can help you.
Each person must enter under his own free will. We will accept no children who are too young to know their own will.
If you are prepared to relinquish all your earthly ties and earthly possessions in exchange for our gift of eternal peace, come to us. Enter our tent.
People of tomorrow, it is the midnight of today.
Come.
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 Come. Enter our tent. Join us.
Arnold!
Watch out who you get in front of, nigga.
This is not a place for you.
We left our farm. Give up our child. Everything for you.
You're sorry for it. I'll get them.
I'll make sure that they both come back. We both listen, we both decide. Come on. I've brought Tim to speak with you.
Welcome, Tim.
May bring your flute. I like your music.
I should have asked them how they knew about the flute. And the moment passed, and I was inside, with all the light, and that sweet smell I'll never forget, and the sound. It was music, and it wasn't. It just crawl down inside your stomach and make you scared to death.
Go now and rest.
Tomorrow is now.
My wife and me were supposed to go with her. She's here. My wife is here. Where is she? Where is my wife?
You just take it easy now. You just take it easy.
Taken them already. Are you talking about that mass hypnosis?
Well, how else could you pull off that kind of vanishing act? I mean, they put me under, didn't they?
Okay. So they get these suckers to attend these meetings all over the country. Then they get them to come down here. And they stage that show of theirs with that their projection machine. Then they hold their big meeting. They hold their big meeting and they put the whole bunch to sleep. Except the suckers. Now why?
Ransom.
Oh, I hope not.
Why did your husband choose to go with them, Mrs. Brown?
I no more believe that my husband went off on his own free will than I chose to sleep in the middle of that damn desert last night.
Sheriff, any news?
Where's that Randall fellow?
My lord, you know what? He went with them.
You know that thing.
Look, if you can't handle it, Sheriff, I suggest you get someone who can. Or don't you care?
I care, Mrs. Brown, I care. But I've got maybe 100 people missing out there. And unless I find evidence of some crime, There is nothing I can do, ma'am. I'm sorry.
Sarah?
Said we didn't need money anymore.
Don't stop, Tim. Play some more. 100 bottles of beer on the wall.
100 bottles of beer. If one of the bottles should happen to fall. 99 bottles of beer on the wall. 99 bottles of beer on the wall.
'll get us started again. Where are we? You know where we are. We're going to town. You mean we're...
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Are you crazy?
We spoke with he and she last night, the both of us, and we agreed to go.
I was drunk out of my skull last night, Lester. Why'd you do this to me?
Arnold, tell her how we could do this to her. I mean, you heard them last night. Arnold, give her the number.
What number, Lester?
Oh, you know, tomorrow is forever and the yesterdays are behind us.
Is that what you heard them say? I mean, haven't you any idea what they meant, what they really said?
Who heard them? I was looking at you. I figured if you were buying it, it was worth buying.
Why did you have to come, Lester?
I don't believe this. You've all been possessed or something. Drugged. You're all crazy, you know that? Turn this bus around. I want to go back.
Look, I can't drive this bus in a dust storm, lady. The engine's all gummed up.
Don't ruin it for the rest of us, please. Some of us have nowhere else to go. I want to go home, Lester. I want to go home. Nobody on this bus was forced to come.
That's right. As soon as we get where we're going, anybody who wants to go back can just ask he and she. But for now, let's just cool it, okay?
How do you know that any of us are ever going to get anywhere? Mandy, I'm scared.
Trust them, Mandy. I'm going to go check under the hood.
We are stuck out here.
In hell, Arnie. That's where you brought us. What is it?
I don't know.
I knew it. We're all gonna die out here.
They know where we are. And she will find us.
Yeah, look where we are. Within an hour or two at the outside, we're all gonna suffocate in this dust.
People, they won't let us die. They're fakes. It's a hoax. They don't care about us. We're all gonna die out here. No, we're gonna die out here.
No. You get your hands off my wife.
She's not your wife anymore, brother. We're all one family.
You are right, John. We are one family now.
Come. We will take you the rest of the way home.
Come.
Come. Come to us.
Let us lead you through the desert. We will take you to the place of the third and final sign. Welcome. We will wait for tomorrow.
Thank you.
Why didn't I stop right there and say to Natalie, let's stay here with the bus? I didn't. Damn it, I didn't.
What are you going to do?
Without some evidence of criminal activity, there's nothing we can do.
Do you have to find his body before you're filing admit there was a crime?
Look, Mrs. Brown, as far as we know, everyone who followed them off was a consenting adult. I have no proof that your husband was abducted.
A man like Arnold Brown does not follow a bunch of illiterate malcontents. He's a leader. He must have been kidnapped.
Well, you bring me some evidence, some hard fact that your husband was physically coerced.
I can't.
That's the problem.
I guess I just want to believe that that's all. I don't want to think that he left me voluntarily. You know, on his own. Where would that leave me?
Beth, about to give birth. And no one to help. Not even a place where we could clean up enough so the baby would have a chance. No water, no food.
She's getting worse.
The only thing I could think of was how to get out. But not the rest of them. Oh, no, not the rest of them.
I miss him. I never should have left him.
Don't grieve, Sarah. You have he and she now.
But what does Tom have?
Can someone here help deliver a baby?
Baby? He or she don't take no babies.
Well, that's not going to stop it from coming. Didn't anybody hear me? There's someone who needs help.
If you believe, he and she will provide. Not a believer. He doesn't belong here.
Hey! You know if there are any doctors or nurses in there?
Doctors? Nurses? We don't need those anymore! Faith! Faith in he and she! That's the only commodity any of us needs now!
Then where are they? Nobody's seen them for 2 days!
He and she will provide!
Oh, damn!
Kim will find someone who can help her, Bob.
He and she will provide.
Where are they, Arnold? I mean, where are they? I mean, this isn't what you led us to expect.
Look, Lester, I never asked you to come. In fact, I don't even want you here.
Get away from him, Les. He doesn't want any part of you. He never did.
Stay out of this, Joan.
No! No, it's time you learned the truth about your friend. Here we are out here in the middle of God knows where, and you're still standing beside him as if he ever gave a damn about you. But what about me? Think about us for once. Let him stand out here in this dust. Let him die out here by himself. I hope you rot here.
Someone in here?
They got us here and they disappeared. The two of them have been gone for almost 3 days now. If I didn't know any better, I'd say this was some kind of bad dream, a terrible nightmare. The only problem is all of these people believe it's real. And it is.
She's getting worse.
Tim will be back soon with help.
They won't let her die, will they?
Beth is not going to die, Bob.
We'd been hoping you'd tell us about Beth's condition. We wanted to give you the opportunity to be honest with us.
We were afraid you'd leave us behind.
There's nothing to be afraid of, Bob. Not anymore. She'll be fine, Bob.
New, Deputy?
Nope.
Oh, come on.
We kind of lucked out, Verge.
Yeah?
That, Reverend McLeish, you know whose name was on that tent permit?
Yeah.
Well, he up and died 6 months before it was issued.
That's all we need.
Applying for a tent permit under a false name, that don't exactly add up to the crime of the century, you know.
A crime is a crime, Boone. That's what counts.
She came and took her away.
You let them take her?
Why didn't you go with her?
Beth doesn't need me now. He and she are with her.
He and she are always there when you need them.
Beth needed them 3 days ago. A cup of tea and some blankets, and we wouldn't need a miracle. Where'd they take her?
There's something wrong here, Natalie. There is, believe me.
No, there's not.
If they can separate Bob and Beth, they can separate us, too.
Don't be silly. I love you.
Bob and Beth don't love each other?
Ready for you now.
Come on, Ali.
No, not Tim.
Natalie's not going without me.
Afraid of. Not anymore.
We shall see you later.
They said you'd play for us, Tim.
Yes, play for us, Tim.
Play for you?
Come on, Tim. Play for us.
Can't you see what's happening here? They are taking away your lives.
This is a play for us, Tim.
There's nothing to be afraid of, Tim. Not anymore.
Come on, Tim. Play for us.
Yeah. Play for us, Tim.
Play for us, Tim.
Yes, play for us, Tim.
Play for us, Tim.
It is time, Natalie.
Just tell me one thing.
Yes.
When I come out of there, will I still love Tim?
You will love him in a way that you have never loved him before.
What it had been like inside that gantry, with the lights flashing and that sound. That incredible sound. I mean, it had to be much worse than the tent. Much worse.
You can go now, Tim.
What am I going to find out there?
Tim.
Beth, you're all right. You're all right. You've got the baby, haven't you?
Baby, Tim? I don't know what you're talking about. There are no children here. You haven't been prepared for the journey yet.
Hello, Tim.
What are you doing? Leave these people alone.
Every one of them came here because of what we offered them, Tim. You came for another reason. You came because of Natalie. We knew that.
Then let me take her...
Choice is Natalie's, Tim.
She has to choose between me or you, your mumbo jumbo and your Halloween costumes. Is that it?
You've made these people crazy.
No, Tim. We offer a gift.
Like taking Beth's baby away?
Beth's baby will be born tomorrow.
You are a good and a very special kind of human being, Tim. We want you to come with us.
Where's Natalie?
You don't want to see Natalie, Tim. Not yet. You wouldn't understand.
Where is she?
Natalie's not here.
know, Tim.
Where's Natalie? Where is she?
Natalie's fine, Tim. We're all fine.
Randall, I've got your story. Help me find Natalie and we'll get out of here.
You don't need Natalie, Tim. Trust them.
Hi, Tim. Have you come to play for us?
We've got to get out of here.
There's nothing to be afraid of, Tim.
Stop it! I love you, remember? You love me?
Of course I love you. We all love you. Poor Tim. You haven't been prepared for the journey yet.
Oh. I'm sorry, I don't know why I did that.
Oh. I understand. I do. But you don't. You don't understand. I have them now. He and she. The two. Natalie won't go with you, Tim.
Natalie has chosen us.
Beth's baby away. But I won't let them take you away from me. I won't let them.
Natalie, come on.
No, you've got to come with us.
Huh? I'll go get help. I'll stop you. I'll stop all of you. I'll stop you. I'll stop you! Come back to us, Tim.
Come back to us, Tim.
The desert is a place of death.
Come back to us, Tim.
Accept our gift, Tim. We offer you life, tomorrow and forever.
The names they used in Chicago, both deceased. The names they used in South Bend, Indiana, both deceased. The driver's licenses they used to rent a car in Birmingham, Alabama, the real couple died in a crash over 4 years ago.
Nobody questioned that they're pros.
Look at this. Our very own Department of Motor Vehicles. School bus purchased 3 weeks ago and registered in that name. The real guy died 2.5 years ago.
How far could they get in a school bus?
Urge. If that school bus used just one tank of gas, we got maybe 25,000 square miles of desert to cover.
At least ways it's on our planet. We're gonna need some choppers.
Yeah.
Settle in. I'm not one of those people. I was just faking it. I told you the only reason I'm here is because I want a story. And the way things are shaping up, I think I got myself a Pulitzer. What? Get some of these supplies here. I don't trust you. Something in there. Put some water in his canteen. Need it, Tim. He and she will provide.
You did let them get you. Oh, the big man with all the answers. What was your weakness, Randall? Huh? What was it?
Don't fight it, Tim.
I couldn't believe they had Randall. I mean, he must have been part of their group from way back. I just couldn't believe it.
It is not our way, Ted. We do not kill.
You were only to speak to him and convince him to return to us.
We must ask for guidance.
Come inside, Ted.
Take it, son.
Drink all you want. I got plenty.
You have to help me. We've got to stop them.
I'll leave you some food. Go ahead. Take it.
Take me to town, please.
You better get some food inside you, son.
Can you show me how to get there?
Who are you? Would you help me?
I already did. Just like they told me to.
I gotta get help.
Lester.
Charlie.
George.
Alpha, Gamma, you know?
Delta.
Delta.
That's it, Delta.
You know that one. This ain't the place, is it?
Nothing.
Ain't no one been here for years.
We're too late.
We'll have someone start searching all the other sites. All these old sites look pretty near the same, boy. We just picked the wrong one.
No, we're too late! They can't have you!
You!
8 months, I've been trying to put it all back together, figure out what happened and why. Now, no one believes me, so I'm on my own. Then last week, I heard that something was going on in Santa Fe. I heard that the two of them have been gathering up their sheep again, and a man answering Randall's description was with them. Now, what convinces me I'm right is that that pentagram is shown in the sky for two straight evenings. Oh, yeah. They're at it again, and this time I'll get them. I mean, this time I'll get them.